Hello students, today we are going to study about the chemical properties of non-metals. Okay, what we are going to study? Chemical properties of non-metals. Okay, so these non-metals, they are electronegative elements. How we can say that? Yes, they are electronegative elements. It means they have the tendency to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself and form a negative anion. Like if we take the example of chlorine, okay, this chlorine will take what? One electron, isn't it? And it will form what? Cl minus, isn't it? So these are what? Electronegative elements. Chlorine is a non-metal. Okay. Now, they have got this non-metals, they have got strong oxidizing, they are strong oxidizing agent. Okay. They have got strong oxidizing power. It means what? With which they react, they have the tendency what? To take the electrons from that, isn't it? Suppose if we are saying about this sodium chloride salt, okay, chlorine is a non-metal in that. What does it take? It takes the electrons from the sodium, isn't it? So they have got the oxidizing power. They are oxidizing what? The metal which is with it, like NaCl, if we are talking, okay, this Cl is taking the electron from here. As a result, it is oxidizing this sodium, isn't it? So here in general reaction, we can write what? This M, which is in the metallic form here, X is what? The non-metal. Naturally, what happens? It is oxidizing this metal with which it is combining and form, making it a positive ion, and itself becomes a negative anion, isn't it? So here, as it has the tendency to take the electrons, they are strong oxidizing agents. Okay, now when we see the reaction with oxygen, okay, they form the corresponding oxides. Okay, those oxides can be acidic or neutral in nature, but never basic in nature. Okay, like when we talk about the acidic oxide example, I have taken of carbon plus oxygen. It forms what? Carbon dioxide. Okay, it is what? A acidic oxide. If we are talking about sulfur, sulfur also combined with oxygen to form what? Sulfur dioxide. Okay, that is also an acidic oxide. Okay, when we talk about the neutral oxides like hydrogen and oxygen, it combines to form what? Water. Here if we are taking carbon and oxygen, okay, in this it has formed carbon dioxide. But yes, if oxygen is less present, okay, what happens? It forms carbon monoxide, and that carbon monoxide is what? A neutral oxide. Okay, now when it reacts with acids and water, does it show any reaction? It doesn't show any reaction. It does not show any reaction because it doesn't displace out what? It doesn't give out what? Hydrogen gas. Why it doesn't give out hydrogen gas? Because what happens here, the non-metals don't have the tendency to give the electrons. And if the electrons are not given, this hydrogen and hydrogen will not combine to form a hydrogen gas. So they never displace what? Hydrogen gas. And as a result, we are seeing no reaction with what? Acids and water. Okay. Now, when we talk about the reaction with hydrogen, okay, so what happens? It do react with hydrogen, okay, to form the hydrides. Like nitrogen reacts with hydrogen, okay, with having specific catalyst of iron, and temperature is also specific, that is 723 Kelvin or 773 Kelvin, okay. It forms what? Ammonia. Okay, likewise, and this ammonia, if I am telling, it is what? A covalent hydride. Okay, here what has happened? They are formed by sharing, and it is forming what? The corresponding hydrides. Okay, now let us see the reaction of the non-metals with halogens. Okay, it reacts with halogens. What are halogens? The 17 group elements. Okay, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay, so here we can see, yes, the non-metals reacts with these halogens. Okay, and they form what? The covalent halides. Like if I am saying hydrogen, it is a non-metal. Okay, it reacts with chlorine to form what? Hydrogen chloride. And the bond here is a covalent bond. So we are saying what? A covalent halide. Okay, like that. phosphorus pentachloride, PCl5 also is formed. Phosphorus is a non-metal and it combines with chlorine, which is a halide, to form what? PCl5. Okay, likewise, and second reaction here, the last reaction which we will be studying about the non-metals, is that reaction of the non-metals with the salts. Okay, and this reaction we can say it as a displacement reaction also. Why? Here you all know this, in what happens in displacement reaction, a very reactive metal, it reacts with what? The less reactive element metal and the less reactive element, and what happens? It displaces it, isn't it? The more reactive element displaces the less reactive element. Okay, so here also what happens? Here we are seeing what? This Br and chlorine, both are non-metals, okay, but the more electronegative element will displace the less electronegative element. So here chlorine is more electronegative in nature, bromine is less electronegative in nature. Naturally what will happen? This chlorine will displace this bromine, and naturally it will be forming what? Sodium chloride, and bromine will be released out. Likewise, here also if we are taking potassium iodide, okay, and here bromine, this bromine is more electronegative now, more than iodine, and as the result this bromine will displace this iodine, and as the result we will be getting what? Potassium bromide, okay, and iodine will be released out, or it will be getting as a residue. Okay, so this is all for today, beta. In the next class we will be studying why these metals and non-metals are combining, okay, the reason behind it and how it is being done. Okay, so this is all for today. Good day, take care.